हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वी डिस्कस द ब्लॉक डायग्राम ऑफ पीक माइक्रोकंट्रोलर। द ब्लॉक्स इन्वॉल्व्स इन एनी पीक माइक्रोकंट्रोलर ऑसिलेटर्स, ए टू डी कन्वर्टर, बोर्ड्स, पावर सप्लाई, रीसेट, मेमोरी ओरिएंटेशन, टाइमर ब्लॉक, सीरियल कम्युनिकेशन, इंटरप्ट्स, वॉचडॉग टाइमर। सो विल सी वन बाय वन। First, we'll see the oscillators, internal oscillators. Mostly microcontroller or any microprocessor operates on 4 to 40 megahertz. This crystal used in microcontroller and microprocessor for providing the clock signals. These clock signals are required for the synchronization of all internal operations like delay between two successive operations. The capacitors are interfaced, or capacitors connected to the crystals, connected in series and grounded over here. These capacitors are there to resonate with the crystal inductance and cause the crystal to oscillate on its fundamental parallel resonant mode. So we'll discuss this later on in our part. Then the ports are given. As I said earlier lecture, that in microcontroller ports are inbuilt. Ports are used to interface any input devices or output devices. Some of the microcontrollers are having 3 ports, some are having 4 ports, in PIC18F having 5 ports. And PIC18 port pin has dual functionality, that means it operate or the operation of any pin is dual. Port A comes with 7 bits, that means 7 pins are assigned for port A. The function of port A is IO and analog inputs. What is mean by IO? IO is nothing but the input outputs. That means you can interface input as well as output devices. Analog inputs means what? It is nothing but, we know any sensor as the output as analog. Microcontroller knows only machine language, so we have to convert that analog value into digital value. So if you want to interface any analog inputs, you can interface on port A. Then port B is 8 bits, that means 8 pins are assigned to port B. It is also have a dual functionality, IO and interrupts. There are two types of interrupts, internal interrupts and external interrupts. Internal interrupt we generally generate through software, whereas external interrupts we can use external interrupt on these pins. Port C, it is 8 bits, it is also as 8 pins are assigned and as a dual functionality, IO and communication pins. Communication pins are assigned for serial communication, SPI protocol, I2C protocol and CAN bus protocol. Port D is also as 8 bits. 8 pins are assigned. It is also has a dual functionality, input output and CCP module. CCP stands for capture compare PWM. Then port E bits, 3 bits. Port E also has a 3 pins are assigned. It is also has a multi functionality, input output as well as analog pins and control pins. Controls are read, write. Then timer, the blocks are T0, T1, T2. In PIC18F we are having 4 timers, timer 0, timer 1, timer 2, timer 3. Basically the function of timer is to generate delay and we can use timer as a counter. It may be up counting or down counting. The timer 0 is comes with 8-bit or 16-bit timer or counter with 8-bit programmable prescaler. What is mean by prescaler? We'll discuss in our next lecture. Timer 1 is 16-bit timer or counter. Timer 2 is 8-bit timer or counter with 8-bit period register time base for PW. Then timer 3 is also used for 16-bit timer or counter. Then WT is watchdog timer. What is mean by watchdog timer? It is hardware timer that automatically generates a system reset. If it is often used to automatically reset an embedded device that hangs because of software or hardware fault. If manual access is not possible, then programmer will design the special function register for watchdog timer in their program. Then memory orientation. The separate memory slots are allocated in any microcontroller. In PIC18, they are given SFRs. SFR stands for special function registers. The special function registers are assigned to do some tasks like timer, serial communication, PWM, A to D converter. So for these operation, the manufacturer assign special function registers in this slot. For example, timer. If I am talking about the timer 0, the manufacturer assign special function register for timer 0 is control register and timer register. Then RAM, program memory and EEPROM. Program memory is also permanently designed by manufacturer. Our opcodes are stored in program memory. Then EEPROM. EEPROM stands for electrically erasable programmable ROM. It is flash memory. We can write program in flash memory. Then reset and power supply block. Mostly microcontroller operate with 3.3 volt to 5 volt, not more than 5.5 volt. Then reset. If any fault occur during software or hardware, we can manually reset our microcontroller function. If you press the reset reset switch, the program or address will start from 00. Then interrupts, I said earlier, interrupts are two types, external interrupts and internal interrupts. Internal interrupts we can generate through timer, whereas external interrupts, it may be hardware interrupt. In hardware interrupt, it is LCD interrupt, ADC interrupt, serial communication interrupt. There are lots of interrupts are there, external interrupts are there. Then next block is A to D converter. We know the sensor outputs are analog. Microcontroller knows only digital values, so that for the process we have to convert that analog value into digital value. So we require ADC. So ADC also comes inbuilt in microcontroller. For conversion we require V reference, a reference voltage. It is not similar like VCC. Then serial communication block. In serial communication blocks, SPI I2C USART comes. The SPI stands for serial peripheral interface. or we can say is a four wire communication. I2C stands for inter integrated circuits. It is also called as a two wire communication. USART is mostly used for serial communication. USRT stands for universal synchronous asynchronous receiver transmitter. If you want to interface any serial communication device like a printer, desktop, LCD, we can use USRT. The two pins are assigned for USRT, that is transmitter TX and RX. SPI I2C, some sensors are comes with this protocol. Or if you want master slave combination, in that case you can use SPI protocol, that one microcontroller will be master and other will be the slave. I2C protocol used with two wire. If you want to interface any memory externally, we can use these protocols.